Hey guys, we're back for a special edition of The Point. I'm your host, Shannon Wiggins, and I'm here today with the city's electric director, Mr. Shawn Dowe. He's here to talk to us about all the great things that they're working on here in the city of East Point. Thank you for being here today with me, Mr. Dowe.
You're welcome.
All right, so talk to me about what your the responsibilities of your department and its day-to-day operations.
So the electric department has three divisions within the electric department. We have the electric line, the system control, and tree trimming. So the responsibilities of each department, the line department, they're to distribute the power from the substations to the residents. System control, they're responsible for obtaining the power from MEAG and making sure that the line department has power to distribute. They're also responsible for commercial metering and traffic signals. And tree trimming, they clear our right-of-ways and make sure all lines are cleared away from trees and that type of stuff.
Mm-hmm. And I know when we've talked in the past just about all the things that you guys are working on, you really stressed that one of your goals is to make sure that we are a smart city. Talk about some of the technology that's being used in your department. Let's first start with the AMI system. Can you break that down and explain to us what that's about?
So AMI, the definition of AMI is automated meter infrastructure. Basically, letting us know what's going on with all our meters that we have within the city. When outages occur, we'll be able to tell firsthand if how many people are out, where is this outage, and that type of stuff. So we'll know, hey, we have this resident, he's out of power, let's go ahead and try to get him back on dispatch crews to that area so we could see what's the issue.
How does this work on the resident side?
So for residents, it's the benefits are tremendous, especially outage times. No resident wants to be out of power, but we could minimize that by the amount of time they're out. Before, it would take an hour and a half, 2 hours to turn a resident back on, and we have cut those times down to 45 minutes now. So, and the other option also will be after residents who's been turned off, the ability to be turned back on right away without an employee, they having to wait for an employee to get to the city.
Does this also allow them to see their usage?
That's correct. So they could see exactly what time of day they're using a lot of power, what time they're not, what different stuff in the house affects the bill. They could see all of this once that customer portal opens.
Are all of the, residents and businesses, do they all have these right now, or are you still installing?
We're still installing. We're about, I would say about 70% on the electric side, and then we're about 60 to 65% on the water side.
Okay. And the SCADA system, when Melissa was here, we spoke to her about how the SCADA system works in the water and sewer department. How does that work for the electric department?
So on the electric side, say right now when we have outages, my line guys have to trace the whole circuit to see where, try to find this outage. With a SCADA system being implemented, it'll tell us the date, the time, the exact location of the outage, where it happens, what phase it was on. So it's reducing our outage times tremendously. The guys will go directly to that outage and be able to repair it within a timely manner.
So you guys are already using this?
No, not as yet.
Okay.
It'll be implemented by the end of June. We should go live with the SCADA system.
All right, we can't wait to see how that works. So what are all these pole labels that we're seeing around the city? Kind of explain what is that about.
So those are that's part of the GPS GIS project. So those are labels for each pole. So each and every pole within the city that East Point Power owns has a label, has a number on it. So each number will be tied to a GPS location. And it goes a little further. Each meter, each citizen meter, each resident, each business owner, every single meter would have a GPS location also. So giving us now the locations of where stuff is happening. And for instance, if we have a broke pole, if a car hits a pole, before the line guys go out to repair it, they already know what was on that pole. Just once again, we're trying to be proactive and not reactive.
Mm-hmm. And if a resident were to see an outage or something happen with the pole, how would they be able to relay that message to you all?
Yes, so in the electric department, we now have a dispatcher. So when they call in and they give the dispatcher, hey, I've seen pole 1, 2, 3, it's a car struck it, it's broken, she could pull that up and relay that information to the line guys so they stock the trucks for whatever they need to go out and replace that pole. Previously, it was going out, driving out there, looking and seeing what's on that pole, coming back to the yard, loading the trucks, you know, just cutting down outage times.
And LED lights. We love lights.
That's a big thing.
Yes. Talk to us about that.
So the city has about between 6,500 to 7,000 lights. So we're changing out all the HPS bulbs, the orange lights, to bright white LED lights. We've already started, we've implemented about 2,000 so far. And that implementation will go on throughout the year. So we'll be completely 100% LED by the end of the calendar year.
What's the benefits of going to LED lights?
So the biggest benefit, especially on the city from a cost point, the LED lights, the vendor that we chose, they gave us a 15-year warranty on those lights. So anything happens to those lights, just anything. If before when we put it up, something happens, it gets messed up, we definitely send that light back. They send us a new one. No cost at all. No cost to the city. So when you think about it, for 15 years, we don't have to buy new lights, literally. You know, I mean, there'll always be a one or two that we'll always have to keep in stock, but for the most part, the big bulk of ordering, that won't happen again.
Very cost effective.
Very, exactly.
And what is this this joint effort with the East Point Police Department in regards to the LED lights?
So we are entering into a joint project, the electric department and the police department, and we're taking, on top of the LED lights, there's a space where you could put a little node on top of the LED lights, and it's called gunshot detection. So it'll send a silent alarm to the police department, to 911, letting them know, hey, we heard gunshots in this area, and they could dispatch crews without, you know, being detected or anyone.
Nice. So when do you think that might be implemented?
That should be coming in fiscal year 20. We've budgeted funds in the capital improvement plan for that project.
Okay.
So July 1st, we'll be jumping right into it.
Sounds good. And like you said earlier, you said nobody likes outages, right? But you all have an outage management system, or is that something you're working on?
Yes.
What is that about?
Yes, we're working on it. And so the SCADA system and the GPS and the AMI, they're part of that overall system. So all of those systems will be reporting to one main system, the outage management system. And it'll take all the calculated information that those three systems give it, and in turn provide us with, hey, this is an outage map the best way to actually to restore power within a timely manner, and if we could do any switching without, you know, the guys actually coming in. So an outage management system will be trying to reduce outages without the guys physically being there.
Okay, perfect. And one other thing, you know, your all's department is very big on using like communication, right? And just making sure there's that connection between you all and residents. How has the Access East Point app and C-Click Fix, how has that helped you all out with getting things done in the city?
That's helped tremendously. A lot of the streetlight issues, a lot of the wires down issues, those are all reported through the C-Click Fix. You know, so we appreciate when residents use the C-Click Fix so we can kind of schedule stuff and get it replaced. So I love C-Click Fix. You know, it's a real nice tool, and it helps us with our planning, for our weekly planning.
Okay, I love it too. Anything else that you want to share with us? Anything you think I might have, you know, missed?
Residents, just I guess be a little patient, but we have some stuff coming up that's gonna be beneficial to the whole city. I know a lot of this kind of work is done behind the scenes that you know we can't share as yet with residents, but within the next couple of months they'll be able to see everything. And just like any of the major power companies, how on their website there's an interactive map, that OMS system will also be part of that. So that kind of stuff is coming up as well.
Okay.
So they could go right on the map and report their outages themselves, or, you know, just kind of see how long an outage is going to take to be restored, that kind of stuff.
All right. Well, we appreciate everything that you all are doing, and we look forward to everything that you'll be doing in the future. And thank you for joining me today.
You're welcome.
All right. And thank you for watching this special edition of The Point. Don't forget to follow us on social media, download the Access East Point app, and also check out more stories on our newsletter, The Verge. I look forward to seeing you later. Thanks for tuning in.